Legend of Total War here with part 2 of my Rome 2 legendary Caesar and Gaul campaign as the Arverni. On the last episode, which was the first episode, took Avaricon and Durotidencon. Fucked name. Anyway, it's a new turn. I'm going to put this druid on these guys to save money. Wait, how much money do I make? 3287 goes to 3436, so increased by about 150. That's not too bad. Alright, what to research now? Just done that. What's this? That costs 4,000. It's out of my price range. Doesn't really give me that much in return anyway. Nope. What else is there? Let's have a look. So, minus 5 upkeep for all armies. That's pretty useful, but costs money. Let's see. Tribal unity. That certainly would be good. It's all Celtic tribes. Would certainly be useful. But we really do need public order, and that provides it. So does that. There's more up this way, but I doubt I'll even get up to there. We'll go with that. 4 turns. Not too long, and public order is now going back in towards the green, which is good. Alright, now what? Speed it up. Or what? Horse pens? Why can't I build horse pens here? That's interesting. I can build them in the city, but I can't build them in the small city. Upgrade that. That was what's urgent. Alright. Now what else? Diplomacy. Let's see. Need trade agreements, non-aggression pacts, defensive alliances, everything. Won't accept it. They probably think I'm weak.
Sit, friend.
I've already got everything with them. Except for some kind of alliance.
My friend. Be well.
No chances of that. Don't know why they won't accept it. Those guys are probably going to be a problem.
Greetings. Speak plainly.
No chance of it.
Idle purpose, and
they're at war with the Pictones, well. So they're kind of busy. How the Vivisci holding up? Hope they lose.
I have little gain in wasting the day on you. What you say had better please my...
I don't think I can do anything. Oh, hang on, these guys don't
well,
mind me.
Met, friend. Satan. I am sure
do I have to
that
pay you for the trade agreement?
Home somewhere, but not with us.
Fuckheads.
You're good. Well, no. You are welcome. Although my
okay, they accept that. Every treaty will help to secure
greetings,
friendship
friend.
With them. Can't do it for them. Guess they don't feel the need for it. That's fine. And I've got no more money, so all we can really do is just go to the next turn. There's Rome. That's definitely something that would need attention if it was bigger, but that's not much of an army. Okay, I've gained some notoriety. Foreign trade up. What's this? Monopolize. Yeah, let's monopolize it. Why not? I like to control everything. Are they on their way towards me? Apparently... Are they on force march? How the fuck can they get to Nemesis? Who is this? He's only got an army of 6. And up against Nemesis, which has an army of 10, they wouldn't stand much of a chance. So it would be silly for them to attack. Unless they intend to attack somewhere else. So they go up this way. I could possibly sabotage them. Plus we could force march our way over there to stop them. They might not even be coming towards me. These Ruteni are getting fucking strong. Really need some sort of alliance with them.
This agreement is like a fee.
Pictones, come on, trade
we
with me,
have
bitch.
Need of talk, I'm sure.
Well, it used to be low, I think.
We have need of talk, I'm sure. But we also need good food, a warm fire.
Okay, we'll try with them.
A flapping tongue that speaks without... I am sure that you're
well. Okay, here we go. They want military access. Let's get some money out of them. Not gonna get much.
I some to be sure, but our hearts are full of. The gods will rejoice at the word.
Maybe later.
You speak as well as a. Good and noble friend.
Nope, they won't accept it. Won't accept it. Come, whatever.
Speak quickly and well. Speak ill or slow.
Let's see if Rome would accept a peace treaty.
Speak quickly.
Low chances.
Do not expect the good wine to eat.
Okay, so I've got 4 grand to spend. Need to upgrade some stuff. Let's get extra food. That'd certainly be useful. Speeding up my army's replenishment rate. And public order. What I need is the chieftain's hold. That's very useful. But it's a technology that's actually not too far away. And that to get better units. Hang on, let me just check. See, that would provide blacksmith with Celtic ballista. That's pretty good. I could get that straight away if I just did this. Ballista would give me a huge advantage over my enemies. Let's get that. And just leave that for now. Yes, we need cavalry, but I can't afford it, so I can wait. Alright, let's move on to the next turn. Hang on, let me just check this again. What does it provide? Tribal unity. Well, it'll be good if they kind of like me a little bit more. Okay, let's move on. Oh, he gets a skill. That's good. If he's getting a little bit better. Good, fuck off, Romans.
Treaties have served us
both whatever. Probably because we're not close to each other. Not a huge concern. 5% wealth from all sources. Yeah, whatever. It's not heaps. Maybe if it was a big empire, it would make a difference. But I'm not. Okay, so I've just researched that. What does that provide? 2 Imperium. If I got this, give me champions. No, I still kind of think I need that. Provides level 1 weapons as well. That's useful. Grab that. Also provides more income. And once again, nothing else to do. Just need to focus on my income. Hang on. Someone over here gets something. Increases authority. Authority, I've found out, or someone told me, actually affects the price reduction of these fucking units. Anyway, let's move on to the next turn. Good. No conflicts happening anywhere. Well, as far as what's going on with me. Gogovia is getting better, which is good. As this goes down, I'll also get more tax rate from them. How much is this province providing me? 1,800. I could also increase the tax rate to... Nah, by an extra 300, it's not worth doing. Not for that penalty right now. When I get bigger, it'll be essential, especially when corruption gets higher. Is there anything else I need to do this turn? Yes, need to get cavalry. What else is there around here with this kind of stuff? There's too many options. Light horse. I'm just going to pause the recording for a second and actually have a look at what the building tree actually does, because I'm not sure. Okay, had a bit of a look. Definitely want to do this. The next upgrade allows me to get heavy horses, at least I think. And that'll certainly be useful. I don't really like light cavalry too much. They're good at, you know, hitting missile units. But as you can see, when the noble cavalry got at me, they just got torn to shred. There's not really else anything I can spend my money on. I could start recruiting. I don't have any sword infantry available. It's all just spear warriors. I hate spear warriors. and that's not going to provide anything. It's going to provide Celtic Ballista, which are good. It's going to make it easy for me to attack Bertigala. Yeah. Alright, we'll just have to put up with that. And move on.
Thank you, great ancestors.
Okay. Now that I've got a fair amount of money, it might actually be an idea to see if I can bring someone into the Confederacy, even if it means having to pay them money. Now, it would be better if I could pay someone that absolutely hates me. So, let's go to him, and if we were to offer my entire fucking treasury...
Not honey.
No chance of it. He thinks he's big and strong. The Rutini, maybe. That would give me a border with Rome, though. The Rutini are... Looks like they've taken out the Arivaki, which is fine with me.
You honor us. There is food enough for two
They're
armies
at war with Rome.
Us when we have talked.
Other way around. No chance of it. I'm not strong enough. If I had more regions, it wouldn't be a problem. Or if these guys felt that... they were in danger.
You honor us.
You speak well, but I fear this...
What about the Aedui?
You have the ear of my people.
I doubt they'll accept it.
Words.
How bad are we, the relations? Pretty bad. Yeah, no chance of it. I could possibly go to war with these guys at the behest of the Pictones. But I'm still concerned about the Vivisci. Hang on, these are under siege. Okay, well, I doubt they're winning the war then. That's fine with me. Okay, don't I have military access with the Pictones? Which means I can go on their land. I do.
Welcome, worthy friend.
Now they want some money out of me.
My people can only dream of wealth like yours.
Not for fucking 70. Forget it. Not right now.
This is trouble.
Alright. This army is not very big either. Get some spear warriors, even though I don't like them. Hang on. Oh, they kind of need to stay here a bit longer for the public order, I think. There we go. Reduces upkeep costs by a little bit again. So if they were to leave this settlement, it's actually not that bad. Okay, stay. Let me see. Actually, what we'll do is we'll force march up to Avaricon, which they can't make it. Just normal march to Avaricon. And recruit some troops as they make their way over there. And you, I want you to have a look at what's going on. Then, actually, now that I think about it, I really don't want to expand up north. I need to consolidate south. Fuck, I should have just stayed where I was. Don't get involved. Problem is, I'm too prone to aggressive maneuvers. Stay down here. You stay there. That'll lose 4 food. Doesn't need the extra public order at this point in time, so we'll just keep it as it is. It might actually be time to recruit another army. If I have 2 armies, it would certainly help against my enemies. And I'm going to recruit that out of Avaricon. Yep, with you. Yep. And we're going to start with the cheap shit. The Celtic youths.
Death in battle, there is no
actually, I don't want Celtic youths. Let me just check. What would be better? The missile attack is the same. So yeah, get Celtic Youths. Alright, moving on. Rome's coming back, but that's not good enough to do anything. Good, extra public order. What's this? For gold and other treasures? Not paying for any fucking ransom. Let her fucking bitch wife die. Don't pay the ransom. Ah, here we go. Now for ballista.
Ready for battle.
Two of those ought to help.
It's a good life.
And some spear warriors. Now upgrading this again. Would give me chosen swordsman and oath sworn. Alright, when does this become available? With that. Shit, being able to recruit Oathsworn will give me a huge advantage over my rivals. Especially early on. So it only take me 2 turns to make that available. But of course, that's expensive. Fuck it, let's do it. Let's go for Oathsworn. Plus, that'll provide extra tax rate as well. It's gotta help. Support of the aristocracy. That's not needed to upgrade. Nope. Alright, well, if that's going to cost that kind of money, we don't want to spend any more. Just leave things as they are. Actually, let's have a look. See if we can bring anyone into a confederation, maybe. The Viviski don't really hate me right now. Now, how are... Well, they still do, but not quite as much. Are they still under siege? Think so. I think not. So let's see if they can join the Confederacy. Low chances.
For me, but please don't bother. Talk of meat.
No chances of it. Can I get another spy? Let's see. Yes, I can get 2 agents. So I want to discover the tribes down here. Who's good? Provide extra growth. Minus 5% cost of all actions. Yeah, we'll do you. Yeah, might as well upgrade these guys as well. Got the money for it. No point in upgrading them. Okay, moving on to the next turn. Yeah, fucking Nemo. I could have upgraded that. No, it's not really needed. Public order here is going quite well. In fact, I could probably increase the tax rate, but the difference would not be great, so don't worry about it just yet. Let's move on. Fucking Romans. Your raiding is not going to help. Managed to reduce my income, though. Yeah, it did. Okay. Gained 5 gravitas, which I don't care about. The Viviski have been taken down. Okay. That only means that another tribe has become more powerful. That would be these guys, who don't mind me.
The guards will have me listen to you, but do not pass the day in words without merit.
Not sure if I want a non-aggression pact with them. They're in the territory that I wanted most. And they're friendly with some fuckheads down here. So it's time to go and have a look and see who they are. Ah, so they've got another unit inside of that. If they attacked it, it'd be suicide. So it's not a big deal. Alright, what else was it that I need to do? Okay, so that's been done. We need that. That's going to cost 4,000. Tribal warrior aristocracy. Go for it. It's going to give me access to Oathsworn. I can't say no to that. Chosen spearman, chosen sword. No, definitely going to want oath sworn, even though they're going to be fucking expensive. They're better than any of the Roman units that they're going to get. Okay, let's move on to the next turn, because I can't afford to do anything else. Well, I can, but... Well, this will provide me with heavy horse as well. If I do that, I'll still have enough money. However, it's going to impact on my public order. Now, public order at the moment is being impacted by the Romans raiding. We can't have that. Let's go deal with them. And yes, we'll force march. Actually, no, we'll just go to Nemesos for now. Maybe that'll piss them off. Who knows? I don't like leaving that region undefended, though. Alright, let's move on to the next turn. Haven't gotten into any battles this fucking video. Yep, he ran away. Good.
The hungry dogs are all around. The wise man bars his doors and looks for shield brothers. What say you?
I say no. Now, are they at war with anyone else at the moment? No. It would be good if they were. Alright, now we need this. Okay, and we need to go back to here. Oh shit. Winter. Duh. Well, that was dumb. That was very, very dumb. Good thing I don't intend to attack anytime soon, but that was very dumb. I suppose it's still functional. Alright, that's been done. Is there anything else around here that's any good? Oh, I can recruit champions now. That'll help. What else is there? 1 experience for all new champions. It's too... I can't afford to get that, though. Let's see. Now we kind of need to get that. Need more public order. Especially for when I conquer another settlement. Wait, when does this become available? With that, yep, okay. Keep them there. Deters anyone else around here from attacking slightly. Let's see if I can get any sort of more agreements.
Well met, friend. Sit and let your words move me to anger or agreement.
They're at war with the Senones. Who are they? They've gotten bigger. That's a big fucking problem.
I have little gain in wasting the day on you. What you say had better please my ears.
Okay, well, hopefully these Turones can keep it up. Just to keep them busy. At least until... my Oathsworn arrive, which will be at least another 6 turns. Alright, well, let's move on. Ah, fuck. Forgot about him. The gods have been
kind. I have talked to a wise woman and all speak of a treaty. And our elders see...
No. Bitch. Okay, so we've discovered these tribes down here, so I can deal with them.
A flapping tongue that speaks without wisdom is not welcome. Be like
these guys can't join the Confederacy because they're of... That's strange. Same culture. No, I won't worry about that too much just yet. We need to take these fuckers down. And just by having a look at them, they don't seem that strong. problem is now, I can't move this guy anywhere while it's winter. You're gonna have to assassinate this guy. What's your chances? Extremely low. Still, we've got the money, give it a shot. Well, hopefully you gain some experience. Looks like it. It's gonna sour my relations with these guys. But, oh well. War will do that anyway. I need a I need a military access through these guys' land.
The guards will have me listen to you.
And trade agreement. Fucking pricks. Reduce upkeep. That'll be especially useful once the Oathsworn get here. Those expensive motherfuckers. How are we going with all this shit? Slaves going down, that's good. Don't need to purchase anything else. I mean, I could do that, but it's going to reduce the amount of food I've got. I don't think it's really necessary. Especially with this being researched. So, again, just moving on to the next turn. I really need those fucking Oathsworn. It's going to make a huge difference. Same with the heavy horses. I much prefer heavy cavalry over light cavalry. Okay. Oh, so these are some of those fucking seasonal shits that happened recently. So, yeah, whatever. Now what? Can't go anywhere until winter's over. They're recruiting now. I need to put a stop to that. Is that a full stack? It is. But they're starving. They're both recruiting. I don't know which one's recruiting more. That one's only recruiting one. This one's recruiting... Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. It's recruiting three extra units. Give it a shot. Who knows? Maybe he'll succeed. Good job. No, they won't finish the recruitment order. Well, they shouldn't. Because their general's dead. Very good. Okay, and again, we just need to wait right here. This guy can be upgraded with better horses. That's certainly going to be useful, because he's going to stick around for the whole campaign. Provided we win, of course.
Honor the gods and your ancestors.
Three more turns until that's available, two more until that. Need to save up some money, I suppose.
Thirsty for battle.
I think I might actually disband some of these guys. Not really going to need them once the Oathsworn get here. Not a big fan of using skirmishers once I become strong. Which I soon will. Okay, move on. Moving on again. No! Piss off. Anyone recruiting? I don't know. Keep an eye on these guys. See, it's not much. Iberian swordsmen. Oathsworn would tear them to shreds. However, the Oathsworn's major weakness is, of course, skirmishers. That's why you need cavalry, which are on their way. The heavy horse. Which aren't going to be that much slower than light cavalry, but they're going to be better in a fight. I might actually get another of these agents, just to... It's not going to provide much money, but it's going to get them experience. And extra public order, that sounds pretty fucking good. You're hired.
Honor the gods and your ancestors.
Druidess. We can also get champions now, right? Okay, let's have a look. Military fervor, that's good. You're hired.
Yeah.
Good, this province is looking really good. In fact, I can raise the taxes now and it's no big deal. Give me a little bit of extra money. Alright, let's go. Just burning through turns here. Should really keep an eye on what the Romans are doing. Okay, my scouts have gained level up. That's good. So, as far as territories, oh shit. Luckily, they're not hostile towards me.
Your people are known to have honor.
They don't really like me, though. Still, I don't think I really need to worry about them too much.
The goddess blesses you. Our warriors will want for nothing.
But I am somewhat concerned. Alright. Oh, they're on force march. Yep, you do that. Provide extra public order.
Ready for battle.
And get experience. Okay, so if I was to recruit those heavy horse, what's the difference? They cost more. Their attack is pretty much the same. Their melee defense is less, but they've got a lot more armor, a lot more health, and a lot more morale. Making them better in my eyes.
Ready for battle.
Let's get four of those, or even maybe six. I don't know, let's get rid of slingers. I don't think I need them anymore. They're not too good in a field fight. One more turn until those Oathsworn are available. When does winter finish? What is this? Early December? We've got another couple of turns. Alright, moving on again. Ah, right. Need you keeping an eye on these guys. If he's recruiting, that's not going to help. He's inside the city. Doesn't matter. Moving on. Okay, so these guys actually want an alliance.
Gratefully accepted is a blessing from the gods to all involved. So say the bones.
Alright, I'm happy to accept this. I've got the money for it. They act as sort of a buffer state towards Rome. See if I can get them to actually join it for nothing.
Sit, friend, and let us talk. And let us
low chances here. Okay, fair enough. Seems like Rome's fucked around a whole lot, though.
For the tribe!
Now then, here's Oathsworn. Okay, they're actually a bit cheaper than I thought they would be. As in their upkeep, that's the only thing that really matters. Because I tend to keep them for a long time. Ah, right. It could be taking into account the fact that I've got the agent suppressing the costs. They're probably a lot more than that normally. They're good units. So, one more heavy horse. And then we need some Oathsworn. That's going to heavily impact on my upkeep costs, though. That's okay. Once I take this settlement, I can make some more money. Public order seems to be quite good. This is almost done, so it's going to be even better. Everything else seems fine. Alright, let's move on. And now it should be spring.
My ancestors are
they're actually willing to pay me. I guess they know I'm coming for them. Treat. Fuck off.
You are strong and wise, and yet I wonder why you stand.
No way.
From
no fucking way. I'm in no position to attack them.
I'm the one your mother warned you about.
Okay, whatever. My income didn't go down by too much, probably because it's now spring. Plus 5% army replenishment, that would certainly be useful. Takes 6 turns though. Alright, what else is there around here? Cultural conversion, no, I don't care. A tribal unity, costing me 2,000. Yeah, it's, I don't know. 10% wealth from subsistence is pretty good as well. That's going to be useful when I get bigger. Still, we need public order. So, we'll get this, and that'll provide public order through that. Plus, I'll get extra replenishment, which I do need. Okay. Now, if I wasn't in the province, public order is still fine. Not sure if I'm going to be able to jump all the way over here, but we still need to recruit some Oathsworn. So two of those and get rid of Levy Freeman. Garbage unit, who cares? And that'll give me 6 loads of Oathsworn. Or is it? No, 5. Still more than what they've got. Go away. Anything else I need to do? Nope, I don't think so. Are they at war with anyone, these pricks? Yes, they're at war with the Tarbellii. Tarbelli, whatever.
A flapping tongue that speaks without wisdom is not welcome. Be like a spear.
If I offered to join the war against them in exchange for money. Oh, come on. Pricks. We'll see how they feel next turn about that. But now would be the best time to attack them, since they're, hang on, what's going on here? They're recruiting, that needs to stop. Ah, you fucking suck. Bring you over here as well. After all, I've got money, so it's not a problem. I mean, my best agent's over here, but I kind of need him here. I don't know why I bother upgrading them, but I did it anyway. Upgrade them as well. It's not that much money. Okay, moving on. Fucking characters. Actually, that's going to save me a little bit of money. So that's not too bad. Boy, how many turns did I just burn? Burned 16 turns, I think, since this video. They still can't make it over here. Ah, they can attack them. That would be alright. Yeah, slaughter them, that'd be great. Alright, who will pay me to go to war with them? No.
The guards will have me listen to you, but do not pass the day.
Give me some money,
without merit.
Bitch. Ah, fuck it. I'll just offer to join it anyway. They've rejected it. Bitch. Probably gonna lose.
You are welcome. Although my ancestors and people...
No, don't call them into fight. They're not gonna do anything anyway. Alright, you need to military sabotage this guy. We can reduce his strength. It would certainly help. I mean, I've got artillery. And they're going to be in a fort. And they're of course going to get reinforcements. But all of those reinforcements put together is not going to do much. Time to go. Alright, so I'm hugely outnumbered. But of course I've got the real strength here. I've got tons of really good units and they've got garbage. Alright, you Iberian fuckers, it's time to die. That looks a bit shit. Whatever.
Ballista!
Alright, I don't know where their ally's gonna come from. Probably from the south. So we do not want to get sandwiched by them. So we'll stay here on the west side. These guys aren't going to be of any use. I'm happy to sacrifice all of these guys. I don't care if they get annihilated. But I need my Oath Sworn to stay strong. And my heavy horse. To stay over here. Keep him with Vercingetorix, because he's technically expendable. If he gets wounded, big deal. Okay, now I know they're going to run out through here. So we want to make sure they've got a little surprise waiting for them.
Enemy reinforcements approaching.
There we go. Would have been better over here. Oh yeah, that's what I like to see. Lots of death. They came on the side that I didn't expect them to. Oh, probably because I got more troops on this side. It doesn't matter. Where are their reinforcements? Well, I don't see them yet. How many kills you guys got so far? I just made it faster for them to get out. That's okay. Now, we're going to want to defeat these guys before their reinforcements arrive, which could be a while, because I don't even see them on the battlefield yet, unless they're coming from behind me, which is really strange, because they're definitely not coming from the south, from the west on the campaign map. Okay, we've dealt a huge amount of damage to these guys, so let's save the ammunition for the second lot. Alright, you guys should be in a formation group. Maybe once you've got a bit of a bigger line. They're definitely not coming from over here. Alright, formation group. And go slaughter them. What's this over here? Iberian swordsman.
Warriors, move out!
Got better horses.
Warriors,
there they are.
Ready.
They're ages away. What we can do is maybe even take the towers so they can shoot down on them as well. Although that seems a bit pointless.
We hunger for blood.
Killing the general would certainly help. It's all just slingers. Slingers don't really matter that much. They'll do a bit of damage, but nowhere near as much as skirmishers. Iberian swordsman. It's perfect to smash with cavalry. Take this dickhead out of the fight.
Our general is under attack.
I just want to take in a little bit of damage. I mean, they're not as heavily armored as Praetorians. Yeah, I don't expect my spear warriors to do much.
Noble horse.
Okay, good. It's all working out well. It's always good to have good quality units. Smashing them once I closed in. Yeah, they're gonna lose. But who cares?
We
Now it's important we also try and kill them all, because this isn't going to annihilate them just because they're inside of a fort. You guys might want to get over here. What I might try and do is actually get inside the fort, huh? And that way, if they crowd around over here, use my artillery to blow the living fuck out of them. And as you can see, my Oathsworn are a clear cut above even the Spear Warriors, which, you know, aren't that much cheaper. Now, hey, go kill this motherfucker over here. And look at the difference with these heavy horse. They've been kicking the living fuck out of these guys. Light horse would have taken a lot of damage by now. Let's take the victory point. Doesn't look like it does anything anyway.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Expectations were low anyway. And they're still ages away. God, my Oathsworn have been tearing these guys to shreds. Even the warriors do quite well. Good, these guys have been beaten. Make sure we run them all down. I want them dead. Now you guys, get inside this, the fort, and have a bit of a break. Okay, no need to chase them all down, they're dead. Nobody owns these towers, they're just sitting there for decoration, for some reason. Maybe it's because they were sabotaged. Alright, we've still got the formation group. Let's get that off. Okay. You guys get over here as well. And now we're defending the fort that we've just taken. I want to redirect these guys in here, primarily for the artillery. And they need to be at an angle, they shoot better that way rather than over them.
Sons of Gorn! Odin! Kill, kill, kill!
You guys need a bit of a break, go for it. We do not need all of you guys to chase after them, just let the general do it because he should be staying out of the fight anyway. Looks like they're redirecting their forces over this way. Very good. Ah, you've got this. Very good. And he's got a whole bunch of other abilities I should be using. What does this do? Unity of Tribes. Extra morale. Don't need that. Well, that helps with fatigue. That's useful. But these guys are fresh now, so that's fine. If they come after my artillery, I'm going to be pissed. Ah, whatever. Also, all this running... Actually, they're walking. If they had run, they'd be exhausted. Maybe I will have to actually go... Oh, hang on. I've got a good opportunity to shoot a whole bunch of them right here. Nothing wrong with that. good. They've all rested up. Good, getting a whole bunch of fucking kills. That's what I like to see. Here they come. But since they're skirmishers, I'm gonna lure them inside. And they'll get shot by these guys. Again, I don't care if these guys get killed.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Okay, artillery's run out of ammo, which means it's time to get out and fight. Get into formation group, even though you're not in a formation, and go fight. And we'll be going round their back. Surprise, motherfuckers, time to die. Oh shit, they've got even more coming. Swordsmen don't really concern me for cavalry. Alright, you guys, go smash the fuck out of them. My Oath Sworn is still in good shape, that's good to see. Smashed them. Good. All of these other units, they don't matter to me at all. There we go, smash into the back of them, get them killed. These heavy horse are doing fantastic now. So much better than light cavalry. Look at them. They've barely taken any damage at all. Same with my Oathsworn. Ultra fucking professional army here. Well, not really professional, but fucking warriors. I can't let them get away. Go chase them down. Well done.
Turning in our favor.
What are these guys? They're fucking shattered. Chase after them. Holy fuck. All of those units getting away? Hell no. All of you guys, chase after them. Except for you, maybe chase after those. How's this going? Oh, they've got a bit of a way to run, so it's unlikely they'll all get away. But then again, my guys aren't particularly that fast. But they do have upgrades, so they should make it. But if I can take out all of these armies in this battle, see, I'm not really that damaged at all. I mean, I've lost a lot of my crap units, but I don't care about them. These are the real damage doers, as you can tell by that 480 kills. These are my Praetorians. Speed the fuck up. Use that. Also provides them with fatigue bonuses. They go straight to fresh. Gallic hunters. Yes, definitely want to kill those motherfuckers. Good, they'll make it. Don't know if they'll kill them all, but they're certainly going to do some damage. And now they're experienced as well, so they're getting even better. and they just get some more experience. But we still have to win every single battle and fight them all manually in order to win this particular challenge. Don't let them get away. It's unlikely these guys are going to make it to that fight, but I'll send them there anyway. You never know, they might.
Elite cavalry!
Iberian tribesmen don't really concern me too much.
Kill, kill, kill.
700 kills, and they've lost one man. Still plenty more to kill. Oh, they've gotten away.
Quick, horsemen!
They might get away.
Ready for battle!
Yep, they got away. That's fine. I think a lot of these are garrison troops, actually. Doesn't matter, they're not going to recover this in a turn. I'm sure that they'd want to be suing for peace. They've been totally fucked over. I get a couple of armies with these kind of troops, there's no way I'll be defeated. And all the tribes will join confederations because they'll know I can't be stopped. Alright, good enough. Obliterated them. What, one unit survived? Ah, fuck it. Holy shit. Too bad I can't finish the attack. Don't have enough movement. Oh well. Anyway, I think this has been a pretty long video, so I'll end it here. Well, we've definitely got this situation under control, unless they can hire fucking 2 full stacks full of mercenaries. And even then, my guys should still be able to triumph. Who cares about these units? They're not important. All that matter are the Oathsworn, which I'm just going to fucking flood my armies full of. Anyway, like and subscribe. Part 3 is next. Don't forget to visit me on Facebook. See you next time.